in a period of 20 months at a cost of 100 crore. With the state-of-the-art technology, if many of you have seen this building, it is a mini airport. The facility has a passenger terminal fully air-conditioned, fully IT-enabled, CCTV system, surveillance system, flight information displays, security hold of 75 passengers and arrival also of the similar numbers. Has facility of a good restaurant,
meeting room,
snack bar,
ATM,
and Wi-Fi. The facility has four hangars of the same size as we are sitting in. This is one hangar. Hangar 1. These hangars can accommodate 8 big body helicopters and 16 medium and small size helicopters. And in addition to that, this heliport has 12 parking bays outside. Presently, we will be working on VFR and very soon it will be a 24/7 airport having independent ATC, fire services, and refueling facilities. Once it is declared operational today, with first flight of inauguration by Honorable Minister, where we will be carrying 5 children from CRI, that's right. Orphan childs, we will be giving a free ride to them all daily today. This is going to be a historic change in the capital, because it will also provide an air connectivity to the nearby states and NCR and intra-city in the future to connect from the various part of the Delhi to the airport and vice versa.
World over there will be about 30. fastest growing aviation sector in passenger terms, which India has already achieved. Helicopters and cargo are still at the minuscule level. Now, if we have to take it up further, we would need a lot of strategies. And strategies will involve skill, and skill will involve training. Without helicopter pilots training, I don't think helicopters are going to work anywhere. And it is high time India thinks of bringing and works at bringing that skill into the country rather than sending people from here outside to get trained outside. So I guess that's a logical request. Obviously, such skill development means employment, means an employment generation, and if aviation itself is to be taken into consideration, a job created here means 6 jobs getting created outside. Of course, applications of helicopter, they are numerous. Right from saving lives to beating traffic conditions, to tourism, to anything. The whole thing is open. And those facilities also need to come to our country. And I'm sure they will come. One thing about this center, MROs are likely to come in here. Because it doesn't make sense parking a helicopter somewhere, getting it repaired in another place, moving it to a third place, for something else. It all tends to push up cost. So how do we keep cost in control? Because if cost can come within control, then only commercial activity becomes viable. This is a lovely facility, 25 acres of land, nearing 100 crores. Somehow, Pawan Hans and me have always found rates to be near the Bata School. When I first asked them to come in with a joyride scenario, they came up with 1,999. And after doing a few joyrides, they realized that if the rates go up to 2,499, it will become very viable and sustainable. And here, you have gone investing 99 crores. And luckily, they didn't say 92 crores, 99 crores, 99 lakhs, 99,999. It does not work that way. But that's how Pawan Hans works. So anyway, it's all very interesting. And this is another feather in Pawan Hans' cap. And I'm sure Pawan Hans will rise to the occasion. It's already the premier helicopter service within the country. It connects very difficult destinations. And if Pawan Hans was not around, life would have been more miserable than it is. So we thank you for that. Thank you for coming around, picking up this facility. I for one have been here before, once before, trying to motivate you. And you have come up after that very fast. And I congratulate all of you, wishing you all the best for the service of the aviation of our great country. Thank you.
Honorable Lieutenant Governor of Delhi. Neeraj, Neeraj, Rajnandini, Varnika, and Nikhil. His children are from the NGO CRY. I would now request all our young passengers to kindly proceed for the security check after they have received the boarding pass. And now the youngest passenger of the inaugural flight received the boarding pass. Let's put our hands together for them. Thank you very much, ministers, for giving the honor. And may now invite.
It's a very happy journey down the memory lane that what was set up as a small helicopter corporation of India in 1985 only for offshore oil exploration and providing connectivity to the northeastern and far flung territories of India, where air connectivity in the modern age and time has become important. The company has taken so many strides, and today they have the unique distinction of setting up the first heliport, multi-purpose heliport, in not only India but possibly in Asia. So congratulations for this successful journey. With the passage of time, when the urbanization is taking its toll on the existing cities, and we see almost all the cities are extremely congested, traffic management is an issue, transporting oneself from one part of the town to the other is increasingly difficult. I think it was only a natural evolution that the helicopter service for transporting people in intra-city movement, not only for intercity movement, had become absolutely essential. Therefore, it's a very good beginning, and I consider it a worthwhile effort made by the Ministry of Civil Aviation and Power Hans Limited. I have received 3-4 requests. I don't want to respond immediately, but I have noted down that there is a request for certain concessions on aviation turbine fuel that the Secretary of Civil Aviation mentioned. I have already talked to the Honorable Finance Minister of Delhi, and I have received a sympathetic response. I would, but as they say, the deed is not done till it is done, so I don't want you to premature start celebrating. I only said that he has given a positive response, but I think it needs to be pursued, which I shall do. Then there is a requirement of some piece of land which is adjacent to this. I think it makes eminent sense. I'll talk to Vice Chairman DBA and see what best can be done. Then one more item mentioned here was about the metro connectivity. Yes, I know that there is a line passing through Rithala, which is about 4-5 kilometers from here. So I will request Ministry of Civil Aviation that Government of India is a 50% partner of this project of metro. So you pursue your partnership. I will try and take it up with Government of Delhi and Delhi Metro to provide this connectivity on priority basis, because I do understand unless and until you have connectivity, the heliport cannot take off to its full potential. So now you have a fantastic heliport. You have a potential to grow it into a hub for heliport, helicopter based, all kinds of operations, training of pilots, the MRO facilities, which is maintenance, repairs and overall facilities. The probably there was a talk of some residential accommodation. I do not know whether the land use will permit that kind of activity, but whatever best can be done, we would like to have an integrated complex which can provide all services together. So with all this now, it's for Mr. Sharma and his team to make the most of it, exploit the market. He has to remember that he is operating in an environment where different technology-based transportation facilities are going to be available. You have metro, you have buses, you have private cars, you have two-wheelers, and this is a helicopter-based operation. Definitely speedier, but all these require very aggressive marketing, co-branding, partnerships, which is the buzzword in the commercial world today. So with all these suggestions and commitments, I wish you all the very best. May this venture be more successful and bring prosperity not only to helicopter corporation, bring good name to India, but also prosperity to the neighborhood here. Thank you very much.
सर कौन ही थोड़ी
देश रोज दिन बे दिन बदलता जा रहा है। और अगर हम एविएशन सेक्टर को देखें तो नजर आ रहा है कि दिन भी दिन हम इतिहास रच रहे हैं। आपको याद होगा कुछ ही दिन पहले माननीय प्रधानमंत्री जी के साथ हम लोगों ने वडोदरा में एक नया टर्मिनल का उद्घाटन किया, बहुत ही सुंदर टर्मिनल वहां बनाया। उसके कुछ ही दिन बाद हम लोगों ने गोवा में शिलान्यास किया, जहां एक पूरा नया एक एयरपोर्ट बनने वाला, माननीय प्रधानमंत्री जी उसके लिए भी उपस्थित थे। और अभी आपको खबर मिली होगी कि बंबई में नवी मुंबई के लिए मुंबई एयरपोर्ट को टेंडर अवार्ड हो चुका है और नवी मुंबई एयरपोर्ट का निर्माण अब जोर शोर से चालू हो जाएगा। ये हम लोग काम करते आए हैं और आज मुझे बहुत आनंद हो रहा है, मुझे बहुत हर्ष हो रहा है कि हम लोग यहाँ रोहिणी में इतना सुंदर, इतना आधुनिक इंटीग्रेटेड हेलीपोर्ट का हम लोगों ने उद्घाटन किया है। रोज दिन पे दिन हम इतिहास रच रहे हैं। इस कार्य के लिए मैं आभार व्यक्त करना चाहता हूँ पवन हंस के सब अधिकारियों को, कर्मचारियों को, जिन्होंने 2 साल में इतनी सुंदर यहाँ एक फैसिलिटी, इतना सुंदर यहाँ एक एयरपोर्ट बना लिया है। मैं साथ साथ दिल्ली सरकार को भी आभार व्यक्त करना चाहता हूँ क्योंकि उन्हीं के सहयोग से और खासकर श्री उदित राज जी के सहयोग से ये एयरपोर्ट इतने जल्दी बन चुका है। और मुझे पूरी आशा है कि आगे के दिन जो जो अभी माननीय उदित राज जी बता रहे थे कि हम लोग यहाँ इस क्षेत्र को विकसित करने के लिए और सुविधाएं लाने के लिए जो हमें काम करना है उसके लिए भी दिल्ली सरकार से हमें पूरी तरीके से सहयोग मिलेगा। साथियों आप कल्पना करें, जब ये इंटीग्रेटेड हेलीपोर्ट कुछ सालों में पूरी तरीके से विकसित हो जाए तो यहाँ आप लोगों को, दिल्ली के नागरिकों को क्या क्या सेवाएं उपलब्ध होंगी। पहली बात तो मैं समझता हूँ ये सबसे जरूरी बात कि मेडिवैक वाली जो सर्विस है, यानी लोगों को मेडिकल इमरजेंसी में इवैक्यूएट करने के लिए हम सुविधा यहाँ से दे सकते, जल्द से जल्द लोगों को एयरलिफ्ट करके हम उन्हें बेहतरीन से बेहतरीन अस्पताल पहुंचा सकते हैं, कितनी लोगों की जान इस प्रकार से बच सकती है, ये मेडिवैक की एक सर्विस हो सकती है। साथ साथ और मुझे मालूम है कि राज्यपाल जी इस पर बड़ा ध्यान देंगे, इस पर चिंता करेंगे कि पब्लिक सेफ्टी की यहाँ हम लोग बहुत सारी सुविधाएं हैं जो यहाँ दे सकते हैं, चाहे वो ट्रैफिक का मामला हो या कोई इमरजेंसी का मामला हो, यहाँ जो हेलीकॉप्टर होंगे उसके द्वारा हम लोग पब्लिक सेफ्टी में हम लोग बहुत लाभ पहुंचा सकते। तीसरी बात, टूरिज्म हम लोग यहाँ बहुत कुछ कर सकते, दिल्ली दर्शन तो यहाँ से चालू हो ही रहा है लेकिन आसपास जो धार्मिक स्थल है जहाँ पहुंचना कठिन है वहाँ इस हेलीकॉप्टर के एयरपोर्ट से आप जल्द से जल्द पहुंच पाएंगे और एक दिन आप जाकर मंदिर में दर्शन करके लौट कर आप घर पहुंच सकते हैं, ये भी सुविधा यहाँ हम लोग। और आगे के दिन जो बड़ी स्पेशलाइज कंस्ट्रक्शन के लिए जो स्काई ब्रिज वगैरह का उपयोग होता है वो भी यहाँ से हम लोग कर सकते हैं। ये सब सेवाएं इतने बढ़िया जो इंटीग्रेटेड हेलीपोर्ट का निर्माण हुआ है आप लोगों को यहाँ से उपलब्ध हो सकते। और जैसे चौबे साहब बता रहे थे और उदित राज जी ने भी बताया, हम लोग और यहाँ ट्रेनिंग इंस्टीट्यूट, हेलीकॉप्टर फ्लाइट सिमुलेटर, ये सब जो अगर हम लोग सेवाएं का प्रावधान करें तो मुझे तो पूरा भरोसा है कि ये हेलीपोर्ट जो है वो हेलीकॉप्टर इंडस्ट्री का एक केंद्र बिंदु बन जाएगा और देश में जो हमें हेलीकॉप्टर इंडस्ट्री को दूसरे स्तर पर ले जाना है, अगले लेवल पे ले जाना है, यहाँ पवन हंस के योगदान से, इस हेलीपोर्ट के योगदान से हम अवश्य कर पाए। और सिर्फ हेलीकॉप्टर इंडस्ट्री का टेक ऑफ नहीं होगा, अगर ये सब सेवाएं यहाँ आपको मिल जाएंगी तो सिर्फ हेलीकॉप्टर इंडस्ट्री का यहाँ से टेक ऑफ नहीं होगा, इस पूरे क्षेत्र का यहाँ से टेक ऑफ होगा क्योंकि यहाँ रोजगार आएंगे, सेवाएं आएंगे, आना जाना होगा, पूरे क्षेत्र को इसका बहुत बहुत लाभ मिलेगा। रेडियो सज्जनों, इन्हीं विचारों के साथ, इसी कल्पना के साथ मैं आप सबको एक बार फिर बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद देता हूँ और पूरी शुभकामनाओं के साथ मैं पवन हंस को बधाई देकर इस हेलीकॉप्टर के आगे के भविष्य के लिए पूरी शुभकामनाएं देता हूँ। बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद। जय हिंद।